Hello dear friends, welcome to the mathematics class. So here we continue the chapter lines and angles. In the previous class you have studied about the corresponding angles, alternate interior angles and angles on the same side of the transversal, exterior angles and the interior angles. So now let us see next section of this chapter, that is checking for parallel lines. You know that what are parallel lines? That is, if two lines do not meet each other anywhere, those two lines are called as the parallel lines. I know it. And you know that if two lines are parallel and intersected by a transversal, then corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, then the angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, that is, sum of those two angles will be 180 degree. So if two lines are parallel, then one thing is corresponding angles are equal, next alternate interior angles are equal, and angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. So these three things you know that in the previous class. Now checking for parallel lines. So how to check whether the given two lines are parallel or not? So now this is the vice versa of these three things what you have studied in the previous class. Means, if two or corresponding angles are equal, here these are the corresponding angles. So if corresponding angles are equal, then these two lines will become what? Parallel lines. Vice versa of this. If two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. If corresponding angles are equal, then two lines will become parallel. And next, if two alternate interior angles are equal, if alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines will become parallel. So this is also vice versa. That means, if two lines are parallel, then alternate interior angles are equal. So next, if two alternate interior angles are equal, then given lines are parallel. And next, third thing is, if the angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, that is, the sum of these two angles are 180 degree, then these two angles lines will become parallel. So this is the vice versa of third thing, that is, if two lines are parallel, then the angles on the same side of the transversal are 180 degree, that is supplementary. So now if the angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines will become parallel. This is the vice versa of the what you have studied in the previous class about the parallel lines. That's it. Let us see. We will write the conditions. First one, if corresponding lines are equal, then two lines two lines are if angles on the same side of the transversal, if angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines are parallel. So these are the three conditions to find whether the two given lines are parallel or not. First one is if corresponding angles are equal. So here it is, corresponding angles. If corresponding angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. If alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. And third one is if angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines are parallel. So this is about to check whether the given lines are parallel or not. So we'll see now exercise. Okay, dear students, let us see the exercise. In that first question, state the property that is used in each of the following statements. So here are some statements they are given. You have to answer which property we have to use in that statement. So first one is, what is that? If A parallel to B, that means line A is parallel to B, this is the symbol for parallel, then angle 1 is equal to angle 5. You know that if two lines are parallel, then the corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, and angles on the same side of the transversal are equal. Now let us see, two lines are equal parallel, then these two angles are equal. So you need to find these are the which type of angles. Let us see, angle 1 and angle 5. So these are on the same side and the same position. So left side and same position. Here also upside and here also upside. Then those angles are which type of angles? Corresponding angles. So if line A parallel to B, then corresponding angles are equal. So what you can write now? If two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. So if two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. That is the property. First one. Second one. So if angle 4 equals to angle 6, then line A parallel to line B. So now just now I said that how to check the two lines are parallel or not. So if corresponding angles are equal, then two lines will become parallel. If alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines will become parallel. And if angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines will become parallel. So now, in those three conditions, which one will apply for the second question? Let us see. So first, check that these two are which type of angles? Angle 4 and angle 6. So here it is angle 4, angle 6. Interior angles in that opposite, that means alternate interior angles. So if alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. So this is the property we have to use here for the second question. So if alternate interior angles are equal, because then two lines are parallel. So this is answer for the second question or property we have to use for the second question. Now let us see next question, third one. What it is? If angle 4 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degree, then two lines are parallel, is A parallel to B. So angle 4 and angle 5, which type of angles let us see? So here angle 4, angle 5. So these are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal, and those are supplementary, that is sum is 180 degree. So means what? The interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines are parallel. So third one is what? If interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then two lines are parallel. So for the third question, property we have to use, that is, if interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, that is sum of two angles is 180 degree, then two lines are parallel. So this is about the answer for third question or property we have to use for the third question. So this is about the solution of first question. Now let us see next second question. In the adjoining figure, identify first one is the pair of corresponding angles. Pair of corresponding angles. So corresponding angles find out in this diagram. So corresponding angles means the angles on the same side and same position. So let us see in the left side and same position. Left side same position. Here also upside the line and here also upside the line. What are those? Angle 4 and angle 8. So angle 4 and angle 8. Next, so downside of the line A, downside of the line B. So those are what? Angle 3 and angle 7. Angle 3 and angle 7. Next, come to the right side. Same position. Upside of angle, sorry, line A and upside of line B. What are those? 195. So angle 1 and angle 5. Next, downside of line A, downside of line B. What are those? 2 and 6. Therefore, angle 2 and angle 6. So these are what? Corresponding angles. Next, second one. The pair of alternate interior angles. The pair of alternate interior angles. So let us find the alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. First, interior angles, which are there? 2, 3, 5, 8. In that alternate means opposite, which are there? 2 and 8, 3 and 5. So those are the alternate interior angles. Alternate means opposite interior angles. So what are those now? 3 and angle 5 and next angle 2 and angle 8. So these are the alternate interior angles. Next, third one, the pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Which are we seeing? So these are the interior angles 2, 3, 8 and 5. So in that same side of the transversal, transversal is line C. Same side, left side which are there? 3 and 8. And right side 2 and 5. So 3 and 8. And next angle 2 and angle 5. So these are the pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. And this is about the solution of second equation. We'll see the next question. Okay, dear students, let us see the next question, third one. In the adjoining figure, line P parallel to Q. Line P parallel to Q. Find the unknown angles. So here, six unknown angles are there. A, B, C, D, E and F. We need to find those angles. How much angles those are? We need to find. So if this figure will be confusing for you means, just turn this one. So how let us see? I think it will be confusing for you. So just turn that figure to the right. So what you can see? So this is line PQ and here it is 125 degrees. This is E and this is F and this is A, B, C and this one is D. So this figure is like this now. So I think it will be confusing for you. So just turn this figure to the right, you will get like this. So now find the unknown value. Let us see how to find. So here now, F and 125 degree are which type of angles? So here angle F and angle 125 degree, which type of angles? Those are what? Or you can take this also. E and 125 degree. So those are linear pair. See that linear pair means what? Two adjacent angles. In two adjacent angles, the non-common arms should form a line. So those are called as the word linear pair angles. So linear pair angles means they will form a straight line. That means sum of these two angles will be how much? 180 degree. So angle E plus 125 degree. This total angle you will get how much? 180 degree. That is linear pair angles. So write that one now. E plus 125 degree, which is equals to 180 degree, because linear pair angles. Linear pair angles. Linear pair means it should form a straight line. Straight line means you know that how much degree it will form? 180 degree. So sum of these two angles will be 180 degree. So now, so take this 125 degree to the RHS. That is like a simple equation. What you have read in the simple equations chapter. So now, E is equals to 180 degree. If you take 125 degree to the RHS, that will become minus. Because plus is there, it will become minus. Minus 125 degree. So E is equals to 180 minus 125 degree. So you will get 55 degrees. So angle E is equals to what? 55 degree. Next, angle F will become how much? That is also 55 degree. Why? Because vertically opposite angles. So these two are vertically opposite angles. And I said that vertically opposite angles are always equal. Therefore, F is equals to how much? F is equals to 55 degree. Why? Vertically opposite angles. So angle FE is equals to how much? 55 degree. Next, angle A is equals to how much? That is also 55 degree because these two lines are parallel. Angle A and angle F are this type of angles. Alternate interior angles and are equal. So you will get A also 55 degree. Next, angle A is equals to 55 degree because alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. And next, angle C will become how much? That is also 55 degree because angle A and angle C are vertically opposite angles. So write that. So this is alternate interior angles to which angle rather? Alternate interior angles or interior angles for angle which one? Yeah. Or yeah, alternate interior angles. So next, C is equals to 55 degree because A is vertically opposite to C. Angle A is vertically opposite to C, and you know that vertically opposite angles are equal, so C is equal to 55. Next, so here it is. We need to find B and D. So how I need to find that? So now here F plus D is equal to how much degree? 180 degree because the angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. So write that. Now F plus D is equal to 180 degree because angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Therefore, F plus D is equal to 180 degree. F how much is there? 55 degree. So right. Or you can write directly D equals to 125 degree also. So first solve this, you can write directly also 180 degree, take 55 to there, R is that will become minus, so 180 degree minus 55 degree, so D is equals to 180 minus 55, you will get 125. Or else you can directly also write D is equals to 125 degree because so here 125 degree and D have which type of angles? Corresponding angles. And if two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. So D is equal to 125 degree because corresponding angles. Those are corresponding angles. So you can use this also, or you can use this also. Whatever or whichever is easy to you, you can use that. Next, angle B will become how much? That is also 125 degree because D and B are vertically opposite angles. So right, angle B is equals to 125 degree because B and D are vertically opposite angles. So, this is how we need to find the unknown angles. So, for A, you can use here corresponding also, corresponding angles also, because we got A and E are corresponding angles, so you will get 55 degrees. So, you will get many conditions. So, you need to write which condition you have to or you have used for writing this answer. So which condition I have used here? Alternate interior angles. But you can use corresponding angles also. E and A are corresponding angles, so you can use that also. So whichever easy to you or whichever it will make sense to you, so you can use that. So this is about what the solution of third question.